About 6.5 or 16 centimetres, this is G.I. Joe Classified Series Movie or Snake Eyes G.I. Joe Origins, Storm Shadow. This is the second Storm Shadow we've had in the G.I. Joe Classified line. The first one was an Arctic version. Anyway, I have a strong belief they'll be repainting that into a nice crispy white all over, and we'll get that at some point soon. However, we're getting a movie version here, so kind of different from the rest of the G.I. Joe Classified line. I've put this next to the movie Snake Eyes, which I've also reviewed. Whilst it was a good figure, there's just some of the colouring is not quite as strong as it could be, and it's not really my favourite Snake Eyes. This is also not my favourite Storm Shadow, and this is really quite disappointing. It's a movie figure. It should be an easier sell, but it's just not that great. And I'll go through the reasons why. And principally, it's only one thing, and that is, as you can probably see, the yellowy nicotine colour. What in the ass was going on? He has elements of his armour that are like that colour, but it's not the entire thing. So, kind of these lapel pieces are that kind of cream colour, but the entire figure in that colour. Now, I get there's logistical problems. Probably the same for Snake Eyes and trying to have tonal differences of grey and black. Yeah, I don't know. I just don't think this has worked. And given this is Hasbro's licence, I feel these figures have not really hit the mark. And it's a bit of a shame because, again, it's their licence. Let's get a closer look at the packaging. We get some gorgeous artwork on the side. Really, really good, which is white. Or cream on some parts, like the shoulder pads there. We get the Arashikaji symbol in the back of the box. Storm Shadow and the Snake Eyes movie down there. On the side of the box, we get all these little emblems, which tell you there's an assassin, a ninja, whatever. It's all explained up in Hasbro Pulse in a blog post. You get the UPC. There you go. And on the side of the pack, we get again just a blow up of that really, really cool artwork. Gorgeous artwork on all these figures. It's the one thing I love about them. There's a really nice pic of Storm Shadow down the bottom, getting his katanas out for the boys and girls. And number 17 in the line, and a little bit of Arashikaji up at the top. But looking good. Nice, solid packaging. So let's get Snake Eyes out of the way and just look at Storm Shadow. So, first of all, facial scan tech likeness. And I should mention, I got this at darksidetoys.com. There's a link in the description if you want to go pick that up. They've also got things like Timber, and lots of other cool G.I. Joe figures, so check them out. First of all, that facial scan tech is pretty awesome. That is really, really quite good. Let me just zoom in even more. That is superb. Yeah, really capture that actor's face. Eyes are spot on, eyebrows, a little bit of a mark. I have seen some of these with a little occasional scar, maybe it's slipping in different places, but I think that facial scan is absolutely bloody excellent and really worth the figure alone, and saves it in my view. It really is super strong. It's one of the best things about the figure. Hair's looking good, really slick. No extra tone, but it's all done solid black across the figure, but really, really good. So let's pop that head off, because there's another one in the pack, and pop on the Storm Shadow mast head. And not quite as strong. Obviously, what they've done is they've painted on the white. So what was a base or the creamy colour, they've then put the pinky flesh on top, and you'll see the difference. See the kind of pinkiness that it causes the paint? It kind of causes the eyebrows to be pink. And it kind of, it's not terrible. I mean, it's just a little window into helmet, so really not a showstopper, but it does affect the final paint of the figure. So it's slightly weirdy, kind of germaline pink, if you know what I mean. It's a kind of antiseptic. Okay, small thing, but not a showstopper. What kind of is the showstopper is this yellow nicotine colour. It is everywhere, and there is no tonal difference, and that is really a shame. Again, when you look at the armour in closer detail, parts like this are done in this creamy colour, and the rest is pure white. Parts like this here are done in that kind of creamy colour, and the rest is pure white. So they've cast it all there for whatever logistical reasons. But I think what they've ended up doing is making the figure look really not great. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Love to hear your thoughts, but real shame. Real, real shame. Now, also, even if you notice on the box and in the movie, he actually has full-length kind of katana sheaths, if that's probably the right word. Whoops. But you don't get them in the figures. So it's not, again, not a showstopper that we get a kind of cutback version of that to make the figure more accessible. I'm fine with that. That's fine. So, but just again, just trying to kind of note some aspects of it. So it does allow the figure to have a bit more flexibility, but that blade jumping around just seems odd. And again, this is Hasbro's property. They should be able to pack in maybe an alternative here. Maybe that would have been simpler, just, you know, full katana sheath there or something, just kind of like the art. But maybe some of this was concept based before the movie was finalized. I don't know, but either way, it is just so yellow. It's really off-putting. Underneath that, the sculpt, I mean, the sculpt on the head's pretty solid and pretty good. The rest of it is quite nice. There's no major issues, I think, with the rest of the figure. It has that nice kind of armor piece, that bone kind of color on some parts of it. The belt as well, nice details on there too. Let me just zoom in again to get some close-ups on parts and sculpts. He does have kind of MC Hammer pants in the movie. They're ridiculously big and baggy. So they have taken a little bit of a design liberty there, which is good to kind of cut that back, because you tend to see him in lots of shots with, yeah, really down to the knees and kind of odd. But down to these boots as well, which again, just were not all this colour. They were not all the one colour. I get it, you know, on a cheaper figure, on a smaller figure, on a little kid's figure, having it all, and in fact, even the versions of this Storm Shadow figure for younger kids have white and different tones. So something's just not right here. It's just not right, and it's, again, it's down to paint and colour. And it's a real shame. Solid figure. There's nothing wrong with it at all. The articulation's there. He is desperate to have a pistol or a gun of some kind, and they do in the movie. So yet again, why, when Hasbro owns this license, they couldn't have packed in a weapon of some kind? It would have just fleshed the figure out a little bit, but it feels like they really didn't bother a lot. And I don't know why. The paint, they didn't bother. The extras, they didn't bother. It's their property. The whole point should be the adding extras and adding details. It's Joe. They own it. So a little bit disappointing, I think, overall for that aspect. No weapons, no shurikens, no nothing. We do get these two blades, and they're good. Got that kind of same white handle, black at the tip, gold, and a little bit of a design all the way throughout. That's it. Great figure. Let down by the colour overall of the paint applications. And it just feels like a figure that's been lying out in the sun forever, and it's really disappointing. Anyway, that's it. What it is, what it is. So articulation on them is really good, actually. We've got a ball joint on that hinge up there. So plenty of movement all the way forward and back, and it's got that kind of neck articulation, so a neck wobble too. You have underneath there a kind of, underneath this top half, it's not really a butterfly, well, it is a butterfly joint really, I suppose. Ball joint up there too. You got a bicep swivel, double joints at the elbows, wrist have full swivel and back and forth too. Ab crunch, pretty solid all the way across, all the way back, plenty of range of movement, and waist articulation, so you get super articulated on these figures. You can on these legs also, as you can just kind of see there, pull down, so you get extra height on the figure if you wanted to. Pegs up at the top of the legs, you get a thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, rocking ankles, and kind of shallow peg holes, but they have them. No stand again. So I just, you know, even the 3.75 inch figures, Hasbro used to put in stands with them. So I don't know what it is. Price point, challenges, I get it, but not great. It is saved by that awesome head sculpt, but this could have been so much more. Such a great figure. Really loads of potential let down by something really simple. Anyway, let me know what you thought. Maybe I've been too harsh, but again, I don't want to, you know, not being a suck up to Hasbro here, that's for sure. But I'm being very fair, I think, in saying had they got this paint right, I think that would have solved a lot of the problems. Let us know what you think, and we'll see you for another review coming right up.